right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Andrew Davidson, the CFO for Eros Resource Corp. And Andrew, it's good to see you. How are you?
I'm great. Thanks for having me on.
Yeah, really interesting company we're learning a little bit more about. First off, why don't you sort of give me a bit of an overview of Eros?
Sure. Well, Eros is a company that is really a two-headed monster, that it's got a great gold asset in Nevada that we're advancing on through the permitting process, our Bell Mountain project. And the other head of the snake is a very large and actively traded equity portfolio that we maintain, focused most specifically on gold assets in North America. So those are the two principal business activities in the company. It's run actively by Ron Nedelitsky on the geological side, mining legend, member of the Canadian Mining Hall of Fame, and prolific mine finder. And myself on more of the financing side, with an active role in the portfolio trading activities, and a very active and engaged board of directors consisting of Ron, Tom McNeil, professional portfolio manager, and Ross McElroy, who's a legend in the uranium space. So a deep bench. It's a small team, but a very, very focused and proven track record for all of the members.
Yeah, let's sort of break these into two parts. Let's talk about Bell Mountain first. As you mentioned, sure. that's the geological focus of it. It's in the permitting stages. So maybe sort of give me a bit of background on Bell Mountain and where you're hoping to get this year with it.
Sure. Now, Bell Mountain is a small project right now, and it was acquired a number of years ago. And, you know, we went dormant on it relatively quickly for a very interesting reason. The U.S. Department of the Navy had attempted to expropriate the property from us because it borders one of their naval bases, Flight Training Center. And so we fought that for a couple of years and finally won back in 2019. So we pulled it out and dusted it off, and now we're getting back at it. And so
you can fight City Hall and win.
you can, yes. Yeah. As long as you follow the right steps. But yeah, you know, interestingly, since we went through that battle, the Department of the Navy has been a terrific resource for us. They've been great partners, and we've held some pretty advanced stage conversations over, you know, joint power usage, all of these things. So the upside to the project is the fact that we have started the permitting process on this asset while we haven't been able to do any expansion exploration work in 5 years. So The project itself is economic in its own right as it currently stands. But I know Ron has a big focus on getting back in the field and growing the size of the project, both just geographically and in terms of potential resource size.
And you'll be able to do that this year.
We think we'll be through the permitting process this year. So
okay. Yeah, that's what I was going to ask you. So that's through this year, and then obviously more exploration in 2022. Yeah. Yeah. Now you mentioned the equity portfolio, really interesting part of the company. This I know that's your baby. So maybe explain to us how that all works and how it aids in the company moving forward.
Sure. Well, I mean, it's tied back to the Bell Mountain project again. When we had to sort of put it on the shelf and go through the legal aspect, we had to decide what we're going to do. And we didn't want to add another asset in that was in a different jurisdiction. So we made a shift over to making some strategic investments in the junior resource space, and have built a portfolio that was, you know, as low as $3 million to one that's worth now, you know, $16 million in equity value, with a couple of core positions in advanced stage and junior companies. You know, our largest holding in terms of value would be Skeena Resources. It's a very well-known company operating out of Vancouver, up in the Golden Triangle there. And then, you know, a real basket of liquid stocks that we can trade in and out of depending on our cash flow needs at Bell Mountain. And that's why we made the choice to go equity portfolio as opposed to different project, knowing that we were going to get through the Bell Mountain issues, and we wanted to have access to capital going forward. So we bought stocks that we can trade out of if we have a major exploration need. And it's gone very, very well. As you can see in our history, we've been to market once for a financing in the last 5 years, and it was a rights offering and out to our existing shareholders. So the business plan has worked quite well, and we look forward really to bringing that forward in a more meaningful way with the work we're doing at Bell Mountain.
Yeah, is that I was going to ask you, is that a long-term goal to continue doing it this way so you don't have to go back to market?
Well, I think, you know, in the long run, we're going to do a mix of both. We'll have to come back to market at some point when it comes time to build a mine in Nevada. Mm-hmm. But until then, we don't really have a need to come back with you know, $16 million of portfolio value as of this morning. And that's on a really bad day in the markets. we're pretty well funded to handle all of our operations.
All right. Well, Andrew, great to meet you and learn a little bit more about the company. It's a fascinating way of doing business, and it seems to be working for you as well. So good luck at the permitting. We look forward to talking again soon.
Sounds good. Thanks a lot for your time.
All right. There's Andrew Davidson, the CFO of Eros Resource Corp.